You come to know a city by remembering it. You remember the route from here to there, the twining path that you walk each day from home to work. A window in a tall tenement building is remembered for the glimpse you once had as a child of a woman's silhouette emerging from the bath. Your parents were married there. In that house, a beautiful woman once lived, a star of the silent screen. In front of that theater, the glittery, famous people of decades past would gather for the premiere of each new film. As you move through the city, you recall all these moments, all these pasts of the city. Now, I shall tell you of the city of Glamour Falls. You reach the city by traveling west, hiking through barren hills until, from atop the ridgeline, you look down and see the city spread out below you, reaching towards the ocean. This is the only way to reach the city, staring west into the setting sun. The city never looks west, only east. Every day, the city watches the sunrise, but never sees it set. A wide boulevard runs west to east through the city. Tall palms line the boulevard, swaying above the low storefronts that abut the street. Small side streets snake outwards from the main boulevard, meandering into the hills that ring the city. Houses and apartment buildings crowd these side streets, shadowed by leafy trees. The streets often seem near to empty. Cars and buses zoom up and down the boulevard. The city never changes. The weather stays constant, always pleasant, warm, and sunny. Every morning, people stand at the corners of the main boulevard. Patiently, they wait hour after hour. They hold signs that advertise star maps. They can, their signs promise, drive you up into the hills for a small fee and show you all the old homes behind whose walls glamorous, beautiful people once lived.
Around the corner, you're on Carrollwood and Sunset Boulevard in Harder, where all the action is.
These people know all the stories of these homes and the past occupants.
Robin Williams, Jerry Seinfeld, and is still showcasing both established...
Everyone who lives in the city knows these houses, knows these stories. They learned them as small children. The stories sung as bedtime lullabies or learned at school as official city history, illustrated with glossy black and white photographs. Each week, the city holds a series of film screenings. Large billboards line the main boulevard, advertising these weekly screenings. It is mandatory to attend. Citizens crowd into the city's numerous theaters. All week, every week, they prepare for these events. What to wear, who to go with. For hours, they sit in the dark, watching film after film, the same week to week. Dramas, comedies, all in black and white. It is a way to remember the past, relive a bygone era, but even more, it is a way to learn how to remember. Slowly, the citizens rise from their seats, seeking to emulate the beautiful people, the beautiful lives they have watched for hours on end. These screenings spill out into the main boulevard from theaters that line the street. The crowds move as one, stumbling into each other, bodies colliding. If you walk by them, they will reach out to grasp you, stroking your arms, your face, your hair. They will gaze at you, lids half lowered, murmuring low words. If you try to join them, though, they change. Hissing, they close ranks, block your passage. If you stare into their eyes, you will see they are clear, small mirrors that only reflect your own face back at you. As you walk down the main boulevard, you will see that the sidewalks are full of cracks. Garbage collects in overflowing, forgotten trash cans. The city has forgotten how to take care of itself, constantly preoccupied with watching a more marvelous, filmic past. No matter how long you stay in Glamour Falls, you will never know it. It is a city without a past. Staring at a street corner, no memory will greet you. If you ask, where did your parents meet? Where did your great uncle live? What store was on this corner years ago? Your only answer will be a blank stare. the people of the city do not know. Instead, they will tell you of a woman who died a tragic death, but was so beautiful, the star of so many films, who lived in the pink house at the end of the block. The house is empty. It always was. The past of Glamour Falls is always its present. It has no memories, but ones created on the back lots of film studios. A tall, white building stands on the hillside overlooking the city. The windows are always shuttered, and a tall hedge surrounds the building. The citizens of the city never talk of the building, nor look in its direction. It is as though they have forgotten it is there. If you stare at it too long, the pigmentation in your eyes will slowly fade away, your eyes turning into two small mirrors.
Exiting the theater, the bright sunlight blinds you momentarily. Unreal city.